Today on Real Chemistry, we're going to talk about something called molarity. What's molarity? Well, it's a measurement of what you might call concentration. And to get a handle on what concentration is, you can see that there's a range of drinks on this slide. And they go from really, really light pink to really, really dark red. And you can imagine that these are all Kool-Aid. And the difference between all these different drinks is how much of that red powder we used when making them. So we've used the same amount of volume of water in each case, but different amounts of powder. And it's nice to be able to look at this and you can tell what's more diluted and what's more concentrated. But in chemistry, we want to come up with a number that can exactly tell us how much powder there is per volume of liquid. So the goal of molarity is just to come up with a number that can express the difference between these drinks. So there's all sorts of different ways to count how much powder is there. But you can imagine in chemistry, we like to use moles because we use moles for everything apparently. So molarity is equal to the moles of the powder that we have there divided by the liters of the water we've added. So we can even get a little more specific than that. Molarity is moles over liters, but it's moles of solute, and that's the thing that's being dissolved. So in this case, it would be that Kool-Aid powder. So if we take the moles of that Kool-Aid powder and we divide it by the volume of that drink in liters, we get molarity. Now these units are really important. You always, always, always have to have moles and liters. Any other units for the amount of powder or the volume of liquid will give you the wrong answer. It always has to be moles over liters. That is the definition of molarity. So let's take a look at some problems where you're going to calculate molarity. This is the most basic type of problem you can have for molarity. It gives you the volume of your solution and the quantity of stuff you're dissolving, and all of your units are right from the very beginning. Let me show you what I mean. Here it says, what is the molarity of a 1.2 liter solution containing 2.4 moles of sugar? So we already have liters of our solution and moles of what's being dissolved. So we're all set to just plug everything into our equation. And our equation, remember, is moles divided by liters. Often you'll see this expressed in terms of symbols. So here you can see that we use this big M for molarity. And then we use N, which stands for moles, and L, which stands for liters. So when you write it out in symbols, you can write M is equal to N over L. And that's what we'll do now. And this is the equation we're going to use to calculate our molarity. So M is equal to N over L. And since we're given our volume in liters and our quantity of sugar in moles, we can just go ahead and plug this stuff directly in. So we have 2.4 moles up top. And we have 1.2 liters on the bottom. Notice we have moles over liters written there. So our units are all set. And if we now divide that in our calculator or just by looking at it, we would get 2.0. And then the way we write the units for molarity is just a big capital M. So what we could say, the way we could express that concentration is this sugar solution has a concentration of 2 molar. So that's kind of a weird way to say it, but turns out you can say it has a concentration of 2 molar. So that's how we calculate molarity. Pretty straightforward. The main complication comes in that they don't always give you volume in liters or the quantity of your solute in moles. And so there's lots of times some conversion problems you have to do beforehand. So we'll go through 2 more example problems where we actually have to do some unit conversions before we can calculate molarity. So in this problem, it says, what is the molarity of 120 milliliter solution containing 1.6 moles of sugar? So the very first thing we want to do if we want to calculate molarity is make sure that we have moles of solute. So that's what I put in our step one. And you notice that in this problem, we're actually already given moles of sugar. So that's nice. We're given 1.6 moles of sugar. So we don't even have to do step one in this case. We already have moles. We also want to calculate liters of solution. And here we have some work to do because our volume is in milliliters and not in liters. So what we're going to do is say, okay, 120 milliliters. And we want to take that to liters. This is a common conversion problem you do in chemistry. And all you got to do is divide by 1,000. So 1,000 milliliters are in 1 liter. And when we do that division, we're going to get 0.120 liters. So now we have our volume in liters. We've done step two. So the last step is just go ahead and plug that into our equation. Now that we have the right units, the problem is just like it was before. It's pretty easy. We plug it into our equation and we'll get the right answer. So our molarity is always equal to moles divided by liters. And our moles we know is 1.6. moles of sugar, and we're going to divide that now by our volume in liters, which is not 120 milliliters, but 0.12 liters, so 0.120 liters. When we do that division, we're going to get out 13 molar. We got two sig figs there because our moles only have two sig figs. And our concentration of sugar in this case is 13 molar. All right, one more problem where now we're going to have to calculate both the liters of our solution and the moles of our solute. So here you can see it says, what is the molarity of a 320 milliliter solution containing 78 grams of sugar? And now we have a problem because we have grams of sugar, not moles of sugar. And we have milliliters of solution, not liters of solution. If you think about it, this is actually the way the problem normally would be if you're actually doing stuff in the lab. We can't directly measure moles, right? We can only go to the scale and measure grams. So more often than not, when you're making a solution, you're going to be thinking about making it with grams, and if you want to calculate its molarity, you have to go from grams to moles. Now, going from grams to moles, we always do with our molar mass. For the sake of time, I've written our molar mass of sugar, in this case it's glucose, down here, 180.2 grams per mole. And so that's the way we're going to go from grams to moles, just as we do in many other chemistry problems. All right, so let's go ahead and do step one, calculate moles of solute. And to calculate moles of solute, we're just going to start with our 78 grams of solute. And we're going to multiply that by a conversion factor where we want to eventually get to moles. And that means we're going to put moles up top. And we always have one next to our moles for our molar mass. And then we write in our molar mass in grams on the bottom, 180.2 grams. Remember that molar mass there is telling us that 180.2 grams of glucose, sugar, is exactly one mole of sugar. And when we do that division, we're going to get 0.43 moles. So that's our sugar in moles. So we're halfway there to the right units. Now we have to calculate the liters of our solution. Again, we're given milliliters and we got to take that to liters. You could be given anything. Sometimes you could be given megaliters, not very common measurement of volume there, but you should be prepared for any different measurement of volume, gallons, cubic centimeters, and being able to take that to liters is always going to be how you're going to calculate your molarity. So 320 milliliters in this case, we do the conversion in the same way, where we know there's 1,000 milliliters in a liter. So we're going to get rid of milliliters by writing it on the bottom, and we're going to get out liters. And there's 1 liter in 1,000 milliliters. We do that division, and we're going to get 0.320 liters. Sweet. Now we have our concentration of sugar in moles, or I'm sorry, our amount of sugar in moles, and the volume of our solution in liters. And now we can just go on to step three, where we just plug stuff in, plug it into the equation. So again, we know that molarity is always, always, always equal to the moles of our solute, the thing we're dissolving, divided by the liters of our solution. And we calculated our moles to be 0.43. And we calculated our volume to be 0.320 liters. And when we do that division, we're going to get out 1.3 molar. So that's our answer. So you can see we had to do a little more work there to get to molarity because we were given grams of our sugar and milliliters of our solution. But the basic way to calculate molarity is always just to get moles and liters and divide them. So thanks for watching this episode of Real Chemistry. If you have any questions, please ask them below. As always, subscribe to get updates about my future videos.